aircraft is not a mere repetition of climbing and descending until landing after departure. When it reaches a certain route, it will maintain constant altitude and do cruise flight. The altitude of this cruise flight section is called cruising altitude. Such a cruising section takes part in the majority of the flight time, and there are international rules made for the safe separation between cruising aircraft. In this video, let's dive into learning cruising altitude. In assigning cruise altitude, we should initially consider the flight direction of the aircraft. Based on 0 to 359 degrees, when flying in the direction from 0 to 179 degrees, odd 1,000-foot altitudes are used, and when flying in the direction from 180 to 359 degrees, even 1,000-foot altitudes are used. In other words, the east is odd and the west is even. Under the fundamental principle, the IFR aircraft below flight level 290, each fly at an odd altitude in the 2,000 feet interval, and to the even altitude in 2,000 feet interval, as illustrated in the image. Thus, the minimum vertical separation of 1,000 feet is maintained between aircraft in flight facing one another. However, the altimeter of an aircraft has an issue in which the accuracy diminishes as the aircraft's altitude increases. Therefore, in flight level 290 and above, in consideration of this point, it requires more separation intervals for safety. For this reason, depending on the flight direction, an interval of 4,000 feet is used as shown in the picture. Hence, the minimum vertical separation of 2,000 feet is maintained between aircraft in flight facing one another. Now, let's look into the cruising altitude assigned to the aircraft taking the actual flight through the flight radar 24. To check cruising altitude, you need to find the aircraft in the cruising stage without climbing or descending. Among the many aircraft, I'll click on this one. That is heading west. Delta 5441 taking off from Appleton and heading to Minneapolis. It is flying at an even altitude of flight level 220. The aircraft that seem to be lined up are high-altitude aircraft. Let's look at these again in a moment. I'll click on this aircraft. Heading southeast. Delta 5326 taking off from Minneapolis and heading for Madison is cruising at an odd altitude of flight level 190. Since there is an increasing number of aircraft used in limited airspace due to an increase in aircraft demand worldwide, the significance of more efficient use of airspace has emerged. Furthermore, there is a constant increase in demand for the assignment of fuel-efficient high cruise altitude, due to less air resistance, and the efficiency was low for basic rules since there were only 7 altitudes usable in flight level 290 and above. That's why RVSM was implemented. RVSM means reduced vertical separation minimum. When flying in the airspace between flight level 290 to flight level 410, it is applying 1,000 feet separation instead of 2,000 feet. In other words, depending on the flight direction, a cruise altitude of 2,000 feet is assigned, in which case a vertical separation of at least 1,000 feet is maintained between opposing aircraft. Through the advent of RVSM, the usable altitude of flight level 290 and above increased from 7 to 13, which can accommodate higher traffic volume. As the accuracy of the aircraft altimeter is a compulsory element, RVSM is possible only in flights that normally operate through specific navigation equipment and received approval from authorities. RVSM is in operations starting from the Atlantic region in 1997 as recommended by ICAO and currently in most locations worldwide excluding certain areas. Now, let's go to the Pacific Ocean to check the RVSM altitude. This aircraft is Asiana 2057 departing from Los Angeles and heading for Incheon, and the current altitude is flight level 380. Clicking on the aircraft. Heading east, Southern Air 962 departing from Tokyo and heading for Cincinnati is flying at an altitude of flight level 330. Let's check the another eastbound aircraft. It is separated by 2,000 feet and is flying at flight level 350. And other aircraft are also complying with the RVSM cruising altitude rules. When a pilot or flight dispatcher prepares a flight plan, they also list the desired cruising altitude by flight direction and whether the aircraft is RVSM applicable. Then, the ACC controller will consider the comprehensive factors like the pilot's proposing altitude, flight direction, traffics, and restrictions to assign the proper cruising altitude. The assigned altitude is sent to the pilot through the clearance delivery prior to takeoff. The cruising altitude may vary from time to time due to factors such as wake turbulence reported during the flight, traffic condition at the time, and weather. The assignment of altitude based on the flight direction, in short, one of the many precautions to prevent collisions in the air. Hence, this is a basic rule that both controllers and pilots must follow. This is the end of the video prepared at this time. Have a safe day. ATC for you.